Now, Tony Stark may have fitted nanobots in his arc reactor, but did you know it's actually been around since 1959? Now we're on our way to creating revolutionary machines and inventions that would rival Iron Man's best gadgets. From stopping a climate crisis to diagnosing disease with precision, nanotech is here, and it's here to change lives. Let's break down how it's evolving and shaping our lives for the better. Let's enter the world of nanotechnology. This cutting-edge science studies the building blocks of matter at microscopic levels. We're talking about atoms and molecules here. If you're wondering why this tech rings a bell, it could be because you've heard this name in Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. Except now, we get to experience it in real life. We can pay our thanks to the brilliant physicist, Richard Feynman, who introduced the concept of nanotechnology way back in 1959. Since then, it's become the fast-growing industry on the planet, and has made way for many applications. If you're wondering what is the purpose of this technology, then simply put, it's game-changing. The goal of nanotechnology is to develop new materials, devices, and systems that are unique even at a minuscule level. Nanotechnology has already raised the bar high and led to many groundbreaking discoveries in areas such as electronics, medicine, energy, and material science. So, how is it doing that? Well, by rescaling and manipulating particles, nanotech creates chemical bonds that are stronger than steel. It allows materials to become more robust, conductive, and malleable. No, seriously, this is revolutionary. This means that with nanotech, we can create materials that are lighter, more durable, and able to conduct electricity better than anything we've ever seen before. Now, this might sound super complex, but nanotech can do this by manipulating nanomaterials. And what are those, you ask? Well, they're minuscule materials. To put it into context, a single red blood cell is about 7,000 nanometers wide. Now, there are two types of nanomaterials, naturally occurring and artificially developed. Of the artificially generated nanomaterials, there are four common types: carbon-based, metal-based, dendrimers, and nanocomposites. Of course, with great power comes great responsibility, and there's always some controversy around new technologies. We're talking here about the ability to transform nearly every aspect of our daily lives, from healthcare to energy, and agriculture to electronics. So, how is it being used today? Picture this: self-repairing roads, bridges, and railways that fix themselves with the help of tiny little nanobots. That's right, nanotech is testing out this revolutionary technology that could fix structural issues and make transportation infrastructure stronger than it has ever been. But that's not all. We're also working on creating synthetic enzymes and ethanol. Ethanol, a finite resource derived from fossils, has many uses, from fuel to household cleaning products. And with nanotech, we can make it in a way that's far better for the environment. Another cool thing? Scientists are trying to invent infinite electricity. Oh yes, you heard that correct. Powering entire cities in a safe and sustainable way has suddenly become a reality. And guess what? We're even replacing computer microchips with nanochips that can store your entire computer and phone's memory on infinite storage units. And these nanotransmitters have been commercially operating since 2014, so it's not too far-fetched to imagine having all our information stored on these tiny little chips soon. We've barely scratched the surface of what this incredible technology can do. Think of it this way: nanobots working alongside super smart AI to predict and resolve environmental crises and help us explore the universe like never before. From creating new climate systems on other planets, to making climate change a thing of the past, the possibilities are literally endless. And if you think that's impressive, just wait until you hear this. Nanotech is projected to be worth a whopping $33.63 billion by 2030, up from its already impressive market value of $1.76 billion. But there's one more revolutionary invention on the horizon. Have you ever imagined being able to fight diseases with tiny robots? Well, the future is here, and it's called nanomedicine. By using materials at the nanoscale, researchers are revolutionizing how we diagnose and treat diseases. With nanoparticles smaller than 1,000 nanometers, we can create injectable drugs that can target a precise location, making treatments much more effective and reducing the chances of side effects. And that's not all. Nanotechnology is going to make doctors' jobs easier. Turns out, they're being designed to create better imaging equipment and diagnostic tools that'll help make a quicker diagnosis. This is going to erase the margin of human error in medical issues by a remarkable degree. They're being used to enhance bone and neural tissue engineering, creating bionic body parts, and even gene sequencing technologies. But here's the coolest part. Scientists are experimenting with using nanobots for medical purposes. Imagine having tiny robots that can transport medication directly to the affected area of your body, just like in the movie Fantastic Voyage. While we can't shrink a crew and put them in your bloodstream, nanobots can make drug delivery much more effective and efficient. And if that's not enough, 3D printing manufacturing with nanoparticles is being used for bioprinting, which means creating living tissues like blood vessels, bones, hearts, or skin via additive manufacturing technologies. So not only are we fighting diseases with tiny robots, but we're also creating body parts with them too. But we're not done just yet. Are you ready to take your health, safety, and performance to the next level? Then look no further than wearable technology. From flexible electronics to contact lenses, wearable sensors are revolutionizing how we monitor and improve our well-being. But wearables aren't just limited to personal health monitoring, they're also being used in public safety. Imagine firefighters being able to ingest sensors and data transmitting pills to track their heart rate, alerting them to potential cardiac arrest or heat stress before it sets in. High-tech headsets are also allowing military personnel to live stream 3D maps of battlefields and different drone feeds, enhancing their situational awareness and keeping them safe. We're compelled to ask, are the possibilities of wearables limitless? Eventually, a lot of biological functions will be overtaken by nanocomponents operating in bionic machines. But with this incredible potential comes a need for caution. Just like mobile devices, wearables can be hacked or infected with malware. Developing protocols for monitoring and securing critical citizen information will be necessary to ensure privacy and security in an increasingly connected world. So whether you're looking to enhance your fitness routine, monitor your health, or improve your job performance, wearable technology has got you covered. The only question now is, how ingrained in our daily lives will these technologies become? And how fast will they extend human-computer interface capabilities? The future is bright, and wearables are definitely leading the way. First up, we have some clever researchers at the University of Michigan who have discovered a way to grow single layers of hexagonal boron nitride on graphene. What's the big deal, you might ask? Well, the boron nitride can be used as an insulator, meaning that the technology could lead to super thin graphene sheets insulated by equally thin boron nitride. Talk about wafer thin technology. If that wasn't cool enough for you, researchers at Harvard have gone and built a laser on a lithium niobate chip using nanofabrication techniques. This little laser is said to be a key player in lithium niobate photonic circuits, opening up a whole new world of possibilities for this technology. But wait, there's more. Scientists at NIST have created an LED using zinc oxide nanostructures called fins, which generate way more light output than existing designs of similar size. And get this, when they cranked up the current, the structure generated laser light. Talk about a bright idea. But what about lower power consumption? Researchers at UC Berkeley have got you covered. They're developing a low power method to use nanomagnets as switches, like transistors in electrical circuits. With their method, we could see electrical circuits with much lower power consumption than transistor-based circuits. And speaking of printing, how about printing your prototype circuit boards with standard inkjet printers? That's exactly what some brilliant minds at Georgia Tech, the University of Tokyo, and Microsoft Research have done, using silver nanoparticle ink to form conductive lines in circuit boards. Who says printing is boring? And last but certainly not least, we've got some exciting developments in the world of memory. From magnetoresistive random access memory to nanotube-based non-volatile random access memory, the possibilities are endless. And let's not forget about racetrack memory, which uses nanowires made out of an alloy of iron and nickel to create dense memory devices. This tech is so hot it's practically on fire. So there you have it, folks. The world of nanoelectronics is evolving at breakneck speeds, with breakthroughs and advancements pretty much every day. Comment below and tell us what advancements have you heard of, and are you excited about any of them? And of course, thank you for watching, and maybe consider subscribing if you like this type of content. And we'll see you in the next video. Take care.